We can only. Ah, better. That's better. Your head, your head.
Okay. One second. Okay. Manishma, how's everyone doing?
Baruch Hashem.
Baruch Hashem.
How are you?
Thank God. All is good. Baruch Hashem.
Enjoying this autumn weather.
Yeah, of course. Before it turns too cold over here. I'm happy to see that your computer is working.
Yeah, me too. Thank you, though.
Yeah. Tov yofi. So I think we'll get started. We're up to Parashat Noach. It's unbelievable how Parasha runs Parasha, and we finished Sefer Dvarim. We're starting again. Maybe I just want to say something, a nice idea that I once learned, that I always like to repeat it, that even though we're doing the same parasha, every year we do again the same parashot, we're doing the same actions, but what is different, or what is supposed to be different? Hi, Eti. What is different? What is supposed to be different? So someone once gave me an example of a spiral, how do you say kfitz banglit?
Spring,
like a spring, right? So it's a spiral thing. It's another circle and another circle, but every time the same spot is higher up than the one before. So even though we're going around and around and around, we're always on a different level, on a higher level. Where we are today, learning Parashat Noach, there's a difference of a year between this year and where we were last year. Spiritually, we learned things. We had different nisyonot. We had different chavayot. Different things happened to us during this year. Different actions, different ways of coping with things. So we're different already. So now when we go back to learn Parashat Noach, it's not the same us of last year. Spiritually, we're on a different level. We're in a different place already. We've changed. That's why in Hebrew, we say Shana, right? Shana is a year. Shana milshon lishnot. It's some kind of a repetition. We're repeating the year. Aval im shinui, the same shoresh, okay? Shana, shinui, lishnot, okay? You'll see that all the Hebrew words for time are referring to the difference, like chag. Chag is also a holiday, and chag is also lachug. It's like a circle going around and around, lachug b'shana, okay? As Kitzel, just to remind us that we're repeating again the Sederot of the Kriyat HaTorah, אבל אנחנו במקום רוחני אחר, אנחנו עברנו דברים, חווינו חוויות, התחדשו לנו דברים, אנחנו במקום אחר, especially because actually this is the first time that we're doing Haftarot. And very interesting when you think about it, we said it many times that the parashot and the months and the chagim, they all go together. Yesh mamash ezeshu yichud. There's a integrazia in Hebrew, we would say. Nachon? Integration?
Integrazia?
Yeah, integrazia.
Okay.
Okay. Between the parashot and the days and everything that's going on at the time and the month. Okay. So when you think about it, We just finished the Yamim HaNoraim. We did Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Sukkot, Shmini Atzeret, Simchat Torah. We started Bereshit. What happens in Parashat Bereshit? Parashat Bereshit, the Kadosh Baruch Hu creates the world. But how does the parasha end? It ends in a very bad way, right? Yeah. God's creation, mamash, it was a big disappointment. There was murder at the end of the parasha. Nachon? Ech? התחלנו בכזה היי גדול, ופתאום בום, הכל מתרסק, crashing down, we go on to פרשת נוח. What happens in פרשת נוח? Again, הקדוש ברוך הוא regrets his creation, he destructs the world, העולם חרב. We have מגדל בבל, נכון? That's פרשת נוח. כאילו, מה קורה פה? We just started the year. We just started on such a big high. Why is everything falling apart? Why is everything coming to a destruction and regret for creating the world and the man? פרשת נוח ends with עם הפסוק שהקדוש ברוך הוא אומר, כי יצר לב האדם רע מנעוריו. יצר לב האדם רע מנעוריו. A person, his יצר is bad from the beginning. So, how are we supposed to be, כאילו, מה נחשוב? מאיפה יהיה לנו תקווה? Where are we going to have any good thoughts? How can we start the year with good thoughts בכלל? And פרשת לך לך, continues. We have Avraham that he has to pick up and he has to leave his comfort zone, his parents, his family, his friends, his city. Lech lecha me'arzecha. Ma kora po? As ze bemet, when you think about it, together with the chagim that we have just finished, I want to take it now and say another thing, even though we're not yet in the haftarot, but we're getting there. We have Rosh Chodesh Mar Cheshvan this week. Right? Wednesday, Thursday is Rosh Chodesh. And we're all familiar with the regular explanation. Why is Mar Cheshvan called Mar? What are you familiar with?
כן, לא חגים.
No חגים. נכון. So, זה הסבר אחד שחזל נותנים לנו. אבל I just learned yesterday a beautiful, beautiful new הסבר. And חזל say that Mar can also mean... bitter, but mar also means a little drop, a little drop. And we learn the whole explanation that I'm going to say now. It's a little bit long, so I'm just going to take the main point of it. But we're going to start asking for birkat hagvurot, נכון? אנחנו כבר אומרות מוריד משיב רוח ומוריד הגשם, and then we're going to say ותן טל ומטר, and it's called ברכת הגבורות. We spoke about it once. Why ברכת הגבורות? Because הקדוש ברוך הוא gives us טיפה ועוד טיפה, one drop and another drop of grain. And we spoke just like a parent that would like to give his child the whole world, all the ממתקים that he asks for, all the sweets that he asks for in the makolet, all the clothes that our teenagers want to buy in the shop, anything they want, we would love to give them everything. But what would happen if we would give them everything? It would be like drowning them in the water. That's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us one drop and another drop. He has to be content. הוא צריך להתגבר על עצמו, על האהבה שלו, לעם ישראל, ולתת לנו טיפה טיפה ולא את הכל ביחד.
זה מזכיר לנו את חוני המאגר.
נכון.
שם הגיע המון המון המון.
נכון.
זה יותר מדי בשבילנו.
נכון. אבל אני הולכת לקחת את זה לכיוון אחר לגמרי, כי זה מה שלמדתי אתמול וממש התרגשתי. When חזל say, ברכת הגבורות, we say האל הגדול והגיבור. We see that these two תיאורים of הקדוש ברוך הוא, גדול, האל הגדול, הגיבור והנורא, הגדול והגיבור, זה בעצם מה שאני רוצה להגיד עליו. יש לקדוש ברוך הוא גדולה. מה זה גדולה? That he has tons of things that he created the world, יש לו שליטה על כל העולם, יש את כל הדברים בעולם הזה שהם של הקדוש ברוך הוא. והגבורה זה ההרמוניה, the harmony, between all these little different פרטים, all the teeny, teeny, weeny little people that he has, the nature that he has, everything, כל הזמן באיזושהי תמונה אחת, בהרמוניה, בתמונה מושלמת, זה הגבורה. And then Chazal explained, I'm going back to Chodesh Mar Cheshvan, that we're leaving the Chagim, we're leaving Chodesh Tishrei on a big high, okay, of the Chagim, Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, we davened, we prayed, we asked for Mechila, קיבלנו על עצמנו דברים חדשים, and we sat in the Sukkah, and we felt the Kadosh Baruch Hu's love and his chibuk, his hug for us in the Sukkah, and now Kadosh Baruch Hu says, קחו עמכם דברים, take things, take something small, אפילו דבר קטן כמו טיפה, כמו מר, from Chodesh Tishrei, and bring it into the life of Cheshvan. Bring it into your day-to-day life. This is now הגדולה של חודש תשרי צריכה להיכנס בגבורה לחודש חשוון. So look how everything goes together. The month, תשרי חשוון, קריאת התורה, that's when we're going to refer to it. הברכות שאנחנו מבקשים בחשוון, מוריד משיב אורח ומוריד הגשם, מזין טל ומטר, הכל ממש מתחבר בכזאת הרמוניה ביחד. מר חשוון, זה התפקיד שלנו, this is our שליחות right now, to take little drops, teeny weeny drops from חודש תשרי, and bring them into our day-to-day life in חודש חשוון. Not to be disappointed that things aren't working for us and that we have to leave the spirituality from Tishrei and how am I going to live such a chomriyut life. This is life. But you have to see how you have to bring something, little drops from Chodesh Tishrei into Chodesh Cheshvan. Afterwards, we're going to cross over to Kislev and over there we already have Chag Chanukah. אבל זה הניסיון הגדול שלנו. איך אנחנו לוקחים את כל הדברים, את הקדושה, מחודש תשרי ומכניסים אותה לתוך החיים שלנו בחשבן. Okay, so I'm going back a minute to the parashot that we started talking about, and we see that first of all I don't want to leave you with the horrible pasuk that we said about the person that he's evil from his from the yesod, from his creation, but I want to remind you that whenever we say me, whenever we have a mem at the beginning of the word, it could be either mem hamakor or mem hayitaron. Yetzer lev ha'adam ra mineurav. We can either understand it in a very negative way, like we explained before, that a person is evil and he will always be evil, and this is the way he is. Or we can learn something else. And this is actually a big nechama that HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells us at the end of Parashat Noach. Yetzer lev ha'adam ra mineurav, he says, the person was created yashar, okay? The person that I created was born in, I don't know if you say straight or maybe amin. I don't know how you'd say that in English, but ben adam shani yatzarti u yashar, he's straight, he has a healthy mind. But what happened in his ne'urim? What happened at the beginning of his life, at the stage of gilad bagot, of his adultery, you say?
Adulthood.
Okay, adulthood. Adultery is a begida. Okay. אז באמת יש בגידה. יש בגידה שהבן אדם שוכח מי הוא, והוא מושפע מכל מה שקורה מסביב. יצר לב האדם רע מנעוריו, הקדוש ברוך הוא wants to say, relax, don't get depressed, don't think that this is the way you're doomed to be. No, you were born in a healthy way, but what happened during your childhood, during your adulthood, during growing up, things around you corrupted you, things around you caused you to act in a bad way. And this is the b'sora mesamachat. At any minute that you choose, you can go back to being a straight person, a healthy person emotionally from inside. Liot chazara ben adam yashar. There's a beautiful pasuk in Sefer Mishlei that says, "Ani barati et adam yashar, v'hema chishvu chashbonot." I forgot the exact words. I didn't look it up. I just thought about it now. This beautiful pasuk in Mishlei that says that a person was born straight, yashar. אבל הם חישבו חשבונות, but things happened around him and he started thinking too much and then he crossed the line. So this is actually a nechama for us, that we can always go back and go back to the beginning of the creation and be in a healthy mind, in a straight mind, just like HaKadosh Baruch Hu created us. Okay? יצר לב האדם רע מנעוריו, זה רע רק בגלל מי שסובב אותו. It's only because of what was surrounding him that caused him to go off the way, off the derech. You can always go back. And now I'm going to transfer to the Nevi'im, to the Haftarot. So the Haftarot, as we say, they're always looking to connect, to be mashlim, what was said in the parasha. So let's start off. I want to show you, first of all, in the paper that I sent you, that we have one pasuk, the underlined pasuk and pasuk tet, okay, in the haftara, ki mei noach zot li, asher nishvati me'avor mei noach od, על הארץ, כן, נשבעתי מקצוף עלייך ומגאור בך. So חזל ask, what is this the only reason that they decided to read this הפטרה in פרשת נוח? Because one פסוק that may נוח is mentioned. So we don't know, we're not going to answer it right now, but I hope at the end of the shiur that you'll all have a good answer. So let's start with the haftarah. If you see, I said the haftarah, there's סידרתי לכם את זה בעצם כמו שזה מופיע. יש פה שתי חלקים. We have two parts. And it's actually even two different parts. One is Perek Nun Daled and one is Perek Nun Hey of Yishaya. And that's the way it's set up for you. And the first part is Roni Akara. Okay, you see that it's, did you get it all underlined and colored and all that?
Yeah.
Okay, I tried לסדר את זה קצת יותר נוח. So our Haftara starts off with Roni Akara. Okay, soon we're going to explain it. And then it crosses over. זה ממשיך פרק נון היי, ענייה סוערה. Okay, so we're not going to learn literally each pasuk, אבל נדבר על הרעיון הגדול שיש פה, because they have Yishayahu, the Navi Yishayahu brings a beautiful, beautiful idea over here in this haftarah. So Chazal feel that they're trying to be menachem, Am Yisrael, after these parashot, that they're starting in a negative way, as we said, the destruction of the world and murder and the gerushim migan eden, כאילו באמת התחיל פה בצורה לא כל כך טובה הפרשות מצד אחד, and the Navi tries to לנחם את עם ישראל, that's what we're doing in the הפטרות. פרשת בראשית לא למדנו את ההפטרה, אבל זה גם נבואה של נחמה. This parasha of Noach is also a נבואה of נחמה. Okay, soon we're going to see, and also next week, Lech Lecha is also Nechama, okay? Nechama for what's going on in these parashot. אז במקום לדבר כל כך הרבה, בוא נתחיל ישר. בסדר. So the main question is, let's start with talking about the galut, okay? What is the main בעיה? What is the trouble or the distress of Am Yisrael in Galut? מה אתם אומרות? מה הבעיה שאנחנו בגלות?
Distance from Hashem, we're מנותק,
Okay, you're talking in a very spiritual way right now. כאילו, את מדברת על הגלות הרוחנית. אני מדברת על הגלות הפיזית. מה הבעיה בגלות הפיזית? Let's look at all of you. You were all sitting in galut until you made aliyah. היה לכם רע שם? סבלתם שם?
No.
Let's turn on your microphone.
No. Life was good.
Life was good. So what life maybe I can and help Hindi just say if you wanna.
Okay. I think that it's more than just that life was good. I think that we recognized that we were trying to fit in, I think, too much more like what everything was like there. And I think that when she says that we're stuck and that we think that this is what we're supposed to be, I think part of the galut that we're in right now is that we are trying so hard to like fit in like with everybody surrounding us that we're forgetting that what our tafkid sometimes is here. I think like we're very influenced, like you said, everything around us, like kamo, like what happened by Noach, and everybody was following there, and that we need to pull ourselves out and have that like realization, like, you know, like everyone last year during Corona, okay, I think Mashiach is coming also, and we felt like Hashem's hand in it. It made us aware, but we're not. We're like very powerful right now. Like we don't realize where we are.
So I want to take what June said and what Hindi said, and Baruch Haba Hindi, by the way, sorry. And connect both of them together. We have one kind of a type of galut. You know, it's interesting because in Hebrew, we would call the galut of America and Europe, galut revacha. Revacha means that everything is very comfortable there. So the present is great. As the kids would say, sababa, nachon? We didn't suffer there. Everything was great. We made a living. Hakol haya metzuyan. But if I continue with what Hindi says, if we think about a future in the galut, there is no future there. Am Yisrael can't develop there, can't be a nation, can't build their HaMikdash. What kind of a future do the Yehudim have in this Galut Revacha? אין להם עתיד שמה. אז הצרה, the trouble of the Galut, in the Galut Revacha, as we can refer to it today, the Galut of today, is that the present is okay. We're not suffering in the present, but we're mainly suffering where we don't even know that we should be suffering, like Candy said. We don't even know. אנחנו לא מודעים לזה that we should be suffering for our future. Because what future do we have in the Galut? נכון? So this is one type of the Galut, that the present is fine, okay? But the future is our suffering. And we have a different kind of Galut. Let's say Galut Mitzrayim. How is their present? Galut Mitzrayim, was their present good? Was their present comfortable?
No, it was terrible.
No, it was terrible. It was horrible. It was a horror for them. And mayum shu'abadim. Don't even talk to me about the future. Now I don't even know how I'm going to end this day, how I'm going to go through this day. Okay? So I want to first emphasize the fact that we have two different types of galuyot. We have one galut that we suffer in the present and we can't even think about the future. And we have a different type of galut that the present is okay. I'm not suffering, but I'm suffering from not having a future. And these two types of galuyot are going to come across in the haftarah. So the first haftarah, the haftarah starts first off with Roni Akara. Roni means it's a word of happiness, of glad, of joy.
Right.
And Akara is a barren woman. Okay. And of course, this is a proverb for the galut of Am Yisrael. So let's think about the barren woman. Okay, is she suffering now in the present? מה אתם אומרות? האישה הקרה, היא סובלת עכשיו מהקרות שלה?
בטח.
איך היא סובלת?
היא הקרה.
כן, אבל בוא נקרא לזה במילים. מה הסבל של אישה הקרה?
She's not fulfilling what she thinks is her potential.
She has no future. בדיוק. העתיד, the future, is projecting on the present. If she would know that, okay, she's going to be barren, she's going to be akara, she'll go through tipulim, but in 7 years, she's going to have a baby, Be'ezrat Hashem. So how would she be living the present in a much better way, right? הידיעה שיש לעתיד, הידיעה שזה יקרה, מאוד מנחם אותה. נכון?
שירה, זה, 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 זה באמת מה שקורה, כי אותו הפטרה שאנחנו קוראים עכשיו, זה ההפטרה של כי תצא. זה הנחמה החמישית אחרי, באמצע שנחמת אותה, זה בדיוק העניין.
זה, הקושי של היום, של ההווה, נובע מעתיד. מי שאין לו בנים, הוא חשוב כמת. אנחנו גם נפגוש את רוני הקרה בעוד כמה וכמה הפטרות, וכל פעם מזווית אחרת. זה מאוד מעניין. It's the same פסוקים, but each time we're going to meet these פסוקים, the Navi brings it from a different point of view. So if we're talking about the הקרה, רוני הקרה, okay, we know that רחל says to יעקב, אם אין, אהבה לי בנים, ואם אין מתה אנוכי. Whoever doesn't have children, הוא חשוב כמת. Okay? עכשיו בהווה הוא יודע שאין לו עתיד. There's no future for him. העם בגלות, okay? Now this is the נמשל. עם ישראל בגלות משול להכרה. Okay? Just like we said before, because even now in the present they're doing okay, they're not suffering in בגלות of today in America and Europe or whatever, אבל they have no future. So how can the Navi be מנחם? How can the Navi be menachem Am Yisrael in this kind of a situation? So let's look in the psukim that I highlighted in red. Okay. I'm going to read the psukim, bet and gimel. I'll start from Aleph, actually. Roni akara lo yalada, זה התיאור. פצחי, רני וצהלי לא חלה, כי רבים בני שוממה מבני בעולה, אמר אדוני. הרחיבי מקום אוהלך. Maybe I'll explain it as I go along, because then I'm going to ask you, what is the nechama over here? Harchivi mekom oalech means start preparing yourself, make your tent larger, bigger, because there are going to be many children that are going to have to sleep in this tent. Harchivi mekom oalech ve'riot mishkenotai chiyatu. Al tachshechi means al tachsechi. Ha'arichi metarayich ve'etodotai chazki. Don't be stingy. Don't try to save money. Buy the best instruments, the best mitarim is a very strong string that you use to tie down the tent. Okay, buy more bedim, materials to make your tent larger. Okay, ki yamin u'smol tifotzi v'zerech goyim yirash. וערים נשמות יושיבי, אל תירא אילו תבושי. I'm leaving the psukim right now. I just want to say what Chazal are telling us over here. Okay? So Roni is Roni Akara means הכיני את הזמירות של השמחה. Prepare your songs to sing from happiness. Because the city, the town, we're talking about Yerushalayim, of course, that till now was Shomema and Azuva, because there were no children to live there. Pitzchi, Rina, v'tzali, start to be happy. Prepare yourself. Prepare your songs, your instruments. Okay, klei negina. Ha'ir she'aita Shomema is going to be now full of children. Ki rabim bnei Shomema. התושבים שהתיישבו בעיר שהייתה שוממה יהיו רבים יותר מבני בעולה. You're going to have many more children. Many, many more children are going to come and sit in the city. Okay? ארחיבי מקום אוהלך, זה הכיני שטחים חדשים למגורים, ויריות משכנותייך יתו, תכיני הרבה חומרי בניין, prepare a lot of חומרים to build your tent, your city, אל תחסיכי בהוצאות, אריכי מתארך וכו'. Chassidei Chabad tell us, there's a story, I don't know if it's true, but they say that in 1990, when Brit HaMoatzot was still closed, the Rabbi Melubavitch, he wrote a letter to the Sarim in Memshelet Israel, the government, and told them that they should start preparing, building city houses, liklot et ha'aliyah that are going to come from Russia, okay, from Brit HaMoatzot. But everyone laughed at him and they said, Aliyah, Russia, Brit HaMoatzot, what are you talking about? Nothing is happening. It's closed. Kilo en sikui. And just a few months later, the nafla achoma shel Brit HaMoatzot, hafach lerusia, ve'amonei olim etchilu lehagi la'aretz. And of course, they didn't have where to live. So they lived in caravans. They didn't put them like the Aliyah from Morocco in little tents, but they put them in caravans. I don't know if the story is true, but this story emphasizes the mashu rayon bemet meod gadol, and I want to say a few words about it. When you look at the nechama, roni akara, build your tents, buy strings, buy more material, bring tractors and make the liasher et hakarka. Ma be'etzem, eich hanavi, ma hakli shehanavi mishtamesh bo kedei leoded et ha'am bagalut? What is, kilo be'emet, what is he saying to us? Ma hakli shelo? What is the instrument that he's using over here to be menachem us? What is he telling us to do?
Giving hope.
Hope, but what are we doing with this hope?
Preparing for the future.
How are we preparing for the future? What are we using?
We're doing actual things.
We're doing actual things, but there's a step before that that Shani rotza leitiches elav.
Yes? When he
says
tying with the knot, it's like you're tying yourself closer. You're getting closer by tying yourself, bringing yourself, getting closer.
But איך אנחנו עושים את זה? באיזה כלי אנחנו עושים את זה? בעזרת הדמיון שלנו, החלום. He even uses the word חלום. I made it red. Wait, let me see exactly the pasuk. Oh, one second, I took the wrong one. איפה זה? Whatever, I don't know. He uses the word חלה. איפה זה? I read it before.
לא חלה.
לא ח... רגע, what פסוק is it?
It's in פסוק א', פצחי רינה וצהלי לא חלה.
נכון. בצחיר הנאי וצהלי לא חלה. חלה, we're gonna use, I wanna use the שורש חלה, בשורש חלם, מלשון חלום. אוקיי? When, מה זה חלום? בוא נדבר רגע על חלום. What does it mean to dream? נכון.
You feel it.
You How do you feel it?
Because you feel like you're experiencing it, like you're actually going through it.
You're imagining it, נכון? And when you imagine a place that you want to be, if you're really going into it, then you could really feel it happening to you. I like to say that the חלום, the dream, okay, הוא מקרין על ההווה. זה משהו מעתיד, it's something from the future, okay, the גאולה, בניין הבית, בניין ארץ ישראל, every person and his חלום, okay? When you really get into the dream, it projects on the present. You could really feel it in the present. It makes your present already feel better. If we're talking about the barren woman, okay, Roni Akara, okay, only the avtacha, the promise that she'll have a child, makes her feel now already much better, even though she's going through, let's say, tipulim and isurim, אבל זה מקל עליה. It helps her live the present because she knows that something good is going to happen in the future. When every day we say in תפילת 18, ותחזנה עינינו בשובך לציון ברחמים, אנחנו מנסות לדמיין איך זה יהיה כשהקדוש ברוך הוא יחזור לפה, כשהוא יחזור למשכן, כשבני המקדש, כשהוא ישכון בתוכי. The דמיון, the חלום helps us. Helps us already now feel better. In coaching, we use it a lot. Because when we ask, what is your dream? Where do you want to be? What kind of a relationship do you want to have? So the next question is, okay, so now that you're able to dream it and see it in your imagination, let's see how we can make it come true in your actions now in the present. Okay, remember, I always give the same example. I have to think about a new example about the young mother that came to me and said that she wants to do coaching to be a better mother. And I asked her, what is a better mother? And then she said whatever she said about having warm food on the table and the house is clean and whatever. כל אחת עם ההגדרה שלה לאמא טובה, אבל בשבילה זה היה אמא טובה. So if you know that a good mother has clean, the children are dressed in clean clothes, as ma ba'aya, can you do a load? Do you have a washing machine? Do you know how to use it? Can you do a load once in 2 days? If a mother hugs and kisses her children 5 times a day, can you do that? כלומר, החלום הזה מאפשר לנו כבר במציאות להפוך את זה למעשה. We say about Yosef HaTzadik, שהוא היה בעל החלומות. What does it mean, בעל החלומות? It doesn't mean that he was in different hemispheres. It means that he knew how to take his dreams and turn them into the present. הוא ידע להפוך את החלום שלו למעשה. נכון? זה מה שהוא עשה אצל פרעה. This is exactly what he did. He had a dream and he knew how to take his dream and turn it into something gashmi, into something, into his everyday life, into the present. So this is the nechama of Roni Akara. Okay? Look into the future and feel it happening right now. Start preparing, like Rabbi Milubavitch said. Okay, בוא נעזוב את זה רגע, ובוא נעבור עכשיו לנבואה הבאה של ענייה סוערה. First of all, what is ענייה סוערה? ענייה is a poverty, okay, is a poor lady. And סוערה is מלשון סערה, a storm. We could use it when we're talking about weather, and we also use it when we're talking about emotions. Ben adam soer, someone that is, his emotions are overtaking him, that he's not, הוא לא מצליח לבסט את הרגשות שלו. Okay, I don't think you use it in English, a stormy person. Would we say that? Is it a מושג שהיינו משתמשים בו? A stormy person?
You mean like a personality?
Yeah. Do you say that in English? In Hebrew, you say it. In Hebrew, it's a bitui, ben adam soer.
It's not a thing, but you could say it.
Okay, but as long as we understand each other over here. Okay, as ania soera, we're talking about a very poor woman and that her emotions are out of control. Maybe that's a better way to say it.
Wait, boy, you say, June, you say in English, he stormed out.
Yeah, you could say that.
Angry.
But you wouldn't say a stormy personality.
No, but whatever. You would say he stormed out.
It's yeah.
Okay,
wait,
so.
Wait, just what pasuk are we on? I'm lost.
Aniyah Soera is the second, it's in the green.
Okay.
It's pasuk Yud
Aleph.
אניה סוערה לא נוחמה, לא מצליחים לנחם אותה, אוקיי? Till now, לא הצלחנו לנחם אותה. Soon we'll see what her נחמה is, but one second. I wanna take you back again. So we said about the רוני הקרה, that her suffering is from the future. כאן להבדיל, כאילו בניגוד לסבל בעתיד, האישה הענייה, מתי היא סובלת? What is she suffering from? Is she suffering from the present or from the future?
Present.
From the present. She has no food to put in her mouth. She has nothing to feed her children. Her children are crying. Their stomach hurts them because they're so hungry. If you think about Shiabud Mitzrayim, if you think about the Shoah, They're suffering right now in the present. They don't even have eyes for the future, okay? הסבל והמועקח שווית שלהם, this is what fills them up. Now it hurts me. Don't talk to me about the future, okay? Someone who's suffering right now, it's very hard to talk to them about the future. I don't know how I'm gonna go to sleep tonight if I'm gonna get up tomorrow morning because I'm so hungry. You wanna talk to me about what's gonna happen when this is gonna be over? אז השאלה שנשאלת, איך אפשר לנחם את הענייה סוערה, אוקיי? העם בגלות משול לענייה סוערה, אוקיי? They have גזרות, they have מוגבלויות, they can't live a normal life, they have a life of poverty, אוקיי? חונקים אותם עם כל הגזרות. איך אפשר לנחם אותם בכלל? מה אתם הייתם אומרות? How can we be מנחם ענייה סוערה? יש לכם רעיון?
You have to turn her into a dreamer.
No, but a dreamer is not going to help her so much.
No, because if you talk to somebody that is in very, very down because of their situation today, you have to give them some kind of spark of hope that they can overcome these things because there is
something to hold on to.
Yeah.
נכון, את צודקת, but you'll see the Navi, he says something, I think maybe even a bit more simpler, if you want to come and be menachem them, okay? What does the Navi say? The Navi says that now, in the present, you should know that everything that you're sitting on is really gems and gold, ואבנים טובות and diamonds, okay? Let's read it a minute and in the psukim and then we'll explain a little bit more, okay? So pasuk yud aleph, aniya soara lo nuchama, it's very hard to lenachem ota. Hine anuchi marbitz bapuch. What does it mean marbitz bapuch? It means all that you're sitting on, marbitz. Maybe I should first just say that, how would you say it in English? Mirvatz. Mirvatz. It also means להרביץ, to hit, להרביץ תורה, but להרביץ is also מלשון לרבוץ, everything that you're sitting on. I'm going to look it up in Google in a second, but meanwhile, I'll just explain that when you find a place where there's a lot of gold, let's say, okay? How would you say it in Hebrew? You say זה מרבץ של זהב, okay? Stratum, is that, yeah, that's maybe the way that we would say it, a stratum, mirvatz. Are you familiar with the word? Am I saying it right?
Stratum. Yeah, stratum, but I think really it means like you're sitting on a gold mine, yeah?
Yeah, yeah, but I'm just saying that the Navi uses the word anochi arbitz, milshon mirvatz, milshon stratum. שהכל פה, you're gonna find out that whatever you're sitting on is a, like June said, a mine of gold, okay? אנוכי מרביץ בפוך, זה אבן נופח, נופח זה אבן יקרה, אבנייך ויסודותייך בספירים, אוקיי? ספיר זה אבן חן, ושמתי קדקות שמשותייך ושעריך לאבני אקדח, וכל גבולך לאבני חפץ, וכל בנייך לימודי אדוני ורב שלום בנייך, So we could go on and on with these beautiful words.
It's like taking a raw diamond out of the mine that doesn't look like anything of any value. And when you polish it and you clean it and you sharpen it, that's when it has its value as a diamond.
Bidyuk. This is the nechama. Right now, you think that you're holding just a little pile of dirt in your hand. But once you'll be able to clean it off and shine it, you'll see that it's going to be a shining diamond. Ze nechama. All what you're going through right now, if you'll just be able to shine it up to clean it from all the dirt and all the bots shedavakbo, ategali sheze yalom. There's a beautiful, you know what, be'ezrat Hashem, I shouldn't forget, ani tzalem lachem v'ani shlach lachem ba-WhatsApp. There's a beautiful, beautiful a prologue for a book that I read once, and she said, she's a Goya, but she says like this, she says that every person has a diamond within him, okay? And of course, she's referring to the neshama, to the nitzotz eloki. But during our lifespan, we throw on this diamond all the dirt, all the people that offended us, all the bad thoughts that we had about, that we have about ourselves, about our reality. Lama ze magia li, ze lo fair, lakhu li, lo ayu ognim klapai, ma ani aseh, eze tzorot yesh li. We take all this dirt and we're covering the diamond. And then we take laka, nail, like, in, I mean, not, it's not nail polish, but laka is like a polish.
Varnish.
Yeah, how do you say that?
Varnish.
Varnish. And we put it around it, we kacha tzuvim et ze, we paint it, and then we think that this is who I am. I'm nice, I'm okay, I have this nice varnish. And she says, her name is Byron Bais. I'm going to send it to you, באמת, בעזרת השם שאני לא אשכח. אם אני שוכחת, אז תזכירו לי, because it's beautiful. It's a short thing in Hebrew, and ממש יפה. And she says, don't believe that all this dirt is who you are. Start coming home, she says. Clean off all the dirt. Make it clean. Look at the big diamond that you have inside. Realize who you really are. היא כותבת את זה ממש יפה. Of course, I'm killing it when I'm saying it ככה, חצי עברית, חצי אנגלית, because of course it's in Hebrew, but אבל זה מתורגם במקור מאנגלית. It's a beautiful book. It's called המסע. That's what it's called, The Journey. The Journey, Byron Bais. And בקיצור, אני אצלם ונשלח לכם את זה, אבל אני רק רוצה להגיד שזה הנחמה של הנביא, back to נביא ישעיהו, ענייה סוערה, how can we bring נחמה to the ענייה סוערה and the גלות that she's suffering every day, every single minute, by saying that you're really sitting on a gold mine, or זה לא כל כך מתאים gold mine, אבל you're sitting במרבץ, של אבנים טובות. This is what the Navi says. You'll see that everything that all that you're surrounded with, everyone, every place that you put your foot down, every place where you live, כל רע בכל רגע נתון, זה באמת אבנים טובות. אבל the nature is that in order to find the gem, the diamonds, the gold, the נחושת, anything good, you have to dig very deep down. You have to work very hard. אז זה הנחמה שהנביא מתחיל איתו. רוני סוערה. So we have שתי זרמים שאנחנו נראה פה with the משלים, the proverbs of עם ישראל. Either as רוני הקרה or ענייה סוערה. And now I want to do zoom out a little bit and talk about two mainstreams over here. Navi Shaya. We started talking about it already before in the last haftorot that we did, but let's remind ourselves that we have two main models of שמאפיינת מערכת היחסים בין הקדוש ברוך הוא לעם ישראל. Okay, יש לנו שתי צורות, two different maybe we can say משלים, proverbs. Okay. Do you remember what we spoke about in our last shiurim? What are the two main meshalim, the proverbs of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and Am Yisrael? We have Eved ve'Adon, נכון? We have a master and a servant. And what is the other one?
Avadin.
Shemati?
Father and son.
Father and son, נכון, but I don't want to speak about it right now. I want to speak of the Chatan and the Kala, of a man and wife. אוקיי, נכון. אבל ישעיהו בעיקר מתייחס לחתן וכלה, לאיש ואישה, ולעבד ואדון, אוקיי? האבא והבן פחות בולט בנבואות של ישעיה. אז לישעיהו יש שתי מודלים ראשיים, and now let's look at them for a minute, and we'll see where Ania Sara and Ronia Kara come in. So when we look at a master and a servant, okay, Bore ve'nivraim, okay, what is the tafkid of the Eved, of the servant? What is the tafkid of the servant? Betzura hachi pshuta, what does the servant do?
Serves the master.
He serves, הוא ממלא אחרי הפקודות של האדון שלו, נכון? You remember אהבה נראה? What מערכת יחסים is this over here between הקדוש ברוך הוא ועם ישראל, if we're talking about עבד ואדון?
That's the יראה.
יהיה יראה, נכון? אני רוצה להגיד משהו מאוד חשוב. When we're talking about עבד and אדון, I think today when we think about servants, we think about it in a very negative way. אנשים בזויים, very שפלים, מתעללים בהם, מנצלים אותם, אבל זה לא הכוונה פה. אוקיי? When הנביא ישעיה talks about עבד and אדון, ביחס שבין הקדוש ברוך הוא לעם ישראל, העבד זה בעצם, זה כמו שר, זה כמו השר של המלך, הוא מאוד מעריך אותו.
It's the difference between a Gentile servant and master, which is very, very negative, and the all the halachot that concern an eved ivri is much different. It puts the eved in even a better, the adon has to give the eved, if there's only one blanket, he has to give the eved the blanket and he goes without.
נכון, thank you very much. זה ממש דיוק. Thank you, Sarah. זה ממש נכון. So when we're talking about eved, we're not talking about the Gentile servant, we're talking about the eved ivri, שהוא מכובד, שהוא מעריכים אותו. אני רוצה גם להגיד, אני אגיד את זה בעברית ואחרי זה באנגלית, כי אני כבר בעברית, שכשמצפים ממישהו לעשות משהו, זה סוג של מחמאה, כי יודעים שהוא מסוגל לעשות את זה, שהוא יכול להיות שם. When you ask, you're not going to ask a five-year-old, oh, please make me a cup of coffee, because you're afraid that he's maybe a little bit clumsy, maybe he's not going to know how to work, how to hold the kettle with the boiling water. נכון? You're not going to ask a five-year-old to do something that he's not capable of doing. But a teenager, of course, can make you a cup of coffee. כלומר, we expect or we ask people to do something, it's actually like a compliment because I know that you can do that. Okay? When I tell my girls, I expect you to overcome your interessantiות, your own interest, אוקיי, אני רוצה שתתגברי על זה ותעזרי לאחותך, זה כי אני יודעת שאת יכולה לעשות את זה. You have the inner strength to overcome yourself ולשים את הצורך שלך בצד ולהתחשב עכשיו במישהו אחר. אוקיי? כמו ברובד הפיזי, גם ברובד הרוחני. אז when הקדוש ברוך הוא מתייחס אל עם ישראל כאל עבדים, זה כי הוא מעריך אותנו, כי הוא מחמיא לנו, הוא יודע שאנחנו יכולים להיות עבדים שלו. אוקיי? זה מחמאה. That's what I want to say. It's a compliment for Am Yisrael to be an Eved. Okay? Because the Kadosh Baruch Hu knows that we can really be there and fulfill what he expects us to fulfill. Okay? When we talk about Chatan Vekala, about...
Baruch Hu talks about David. David Avdi.
נכון.
And that is one of the most na'ale experiences that you could have, is that he's considered Eved Hashem.
נכון, זה מחמאה, זה דבר הכי גדול לבן אדם להיות עבד השם. We say it in הלל, אני עבדך בין המתך, פיתחת למוסריי. We're proud to be עבדים, נכון? I also want to say that the מערכת יחסים of איש ואישה, של אינטימיות, של חתן וכלה, זה מערכת יחסים של עבודת השם מאהבה. And we said it many times, אבל אני רוצה להזכיר לכם, לפעמים אנחנו בבחינת עבד, ולפעמים אנחנו בבחינת איש ואישה, okay? It's not either this or this, okay? We spoke about it a lot as stages, and יראה זה קודם לאהבה, זה מביא לאהבה, אבל היום אנחנו במקום שלפעמים אנחנו עובדים מאהבה ולפעמים מיראה, אנחנו משלימים את עצמנו אחד את השני. Okay, בוא נמשיך עוד טיפה. רוני הקרה, okay? Ronia Kara, we're back to the first proverb of the Haftarah. It says about Roni Akara that she's Eshet Neurim. I also highlighted in red. What does it mean, Eshet Neurim? Eshet Neurim is like the first love, okay? This is a couple that got married young. This is his first love of his life. Lo yaaleh al hadaat, we can't imagine that that the first love, the Eshet Neurim, will be forgotten. Okay, and now we're going a little bit deeper into this mashal of Roni Akara. The Navi Yishaya wants to tell us that the Geula that's going to come, the redemption of Roni Akara, is, if this is Avodat Hashem Me'ava, we're talking about the intimiut ben Ish Leisha, אז למה הקדוש ברוך הוא יגאל את רוני הכרה, את ההכרה? לא בגלל שהיא תקיים מצוות, לא בגלל שהיא פתאום תעלה על דרך המלך. בזכות מה הוא יגאל אותה? מה אתם אומרות?
על האהבה שביניהם.
בדיוק.
ואת צחקתי לך חסד נורייך.
נכון.
Say in English, please.
Why is HaKadosh Baruch Hu going to ligol et Am Yisrael when we're thinking about Roni Akara, Marechet Yechasim shel Ahava?
Right, what's ligol?
Redeem. Okay. Why is HaKadosh Baruch Hu going to come back to his Eshet Neurim? Because he loves her. Because he knows her personality and he's never going to leave her. You know that what they say, that when there's the midrash that say that when they כשפרצו להיכל אחרי שעם ישראל יצא לגלות, they saw that the קרובים were facing each other. Of course we expected that if עם ישראל and הקדוש ברוך הוא בנתק, and הקדוש ברוך הוא is angry at עם ישראל, then the קרובים would be outward, very angry at each other. But no, ממשילים את הגלות של עם ישראל, זה כמו איש ואישה שהיה להם מריבה, they had a fight, a husband and a woman, and his wife, they had a fight, and he stormed out of the house because he's very angry, but the wife knows, the lady knows that he's going to come back for her, right? Okay, אז היה מריבה. It even says in the psukim, פסוק זין, ברגע קטון עזבתיך, we had a little fight, and one little minute I left you, וברחמים גדולים אקבצך, and I'm going to come back for you, I love you, okay? Your geula is going to be because I love you, because I know who you are, I appreciate you, okay? לעומת זאת, when we talk about ענייה סוערה, that is very poor, she's living in poverty, למה לדעתכם הקדוש ברוך הוא יגאל את הענייה סוערה? If we're talking about עבד אין אדון, למה שהוא יגאל את הענייה הזאת? כי הוא מרחם עליה. He feels bad for her. He feels bad for his servant that he went wrong, he went off the way, okay, and he's sitting now in poverty and he's suffering. He feels bad for her. Okay, he also gives them some kind of a tnai. How do you say tnai in English?
Condition.
Okay, he conditions it that if they be mekayem Torah and mitzvot, so then he will redeem them. Okay? אז עכשיו בוא נעשה איזושהי הסתכלות חיצונית מבחוץ על כל הדבר הזה, כי זה מאוד מעניין. So Chazal, not Chazal, Ishayahu, it's Chazal, because Chazal chose the Haftarot. So we have the first part of the Haftarah of Roni Akara, okay? And then we have the second part of Aniya Sohara. And of course, we ask, Chazal asks, why do we need also Roni Akara and also Aniya Sohara? Isn't it enough just one of them? So Chazal say that they complete each other, okay? Because these are two main streams in Am Yisrael. Okay, we have sometimes we have galut of Roni Akara, okay, of the barren woman, okay, that has no children and she's troubled from the future, and then HaKadosh Baruch Hu menachem ota b'tzura hazot of the chalom, of the dream, we spoke about it, and sometimes we have the galut of Aniya Sohara, that now I don't know how I'm going to live, my day-to-day life, I don't know how I'm going to finish this day. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu menachem otanu to turn all the dirt that we're sitting in, the dirt is going to turn into gemstones, into rhinestones, diamonds, gold, you name it. Okay? So if we can put it all like in a table, okay, I'm going to try to say this a little bit fast because I still want to get back to Noach to say something nice about Noach, lekasher etzeh leNoach atzmo. Okay? So when we think about Roni Akara, we said that her main problem is the future, and the lady that's living in poverty, her main problem or her main ke'ev is al ha'oveh, okay, her suffering in the present. What is the nechama for the Akara? Ba'atid, okay, achalom. Think about the children that you're going to have. Harchivi mekom o'alech. And when we're talking to the Aniya, her nechama is turning the dirt into stones, into diamonds, okay? The Ma'arechet Yechasim of Am Yisrael and HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the first Mashal of the Akara is like a man and wife, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to be goel them because of the love for him. And the lady that's sitting in poverty, she's like the Ma'arechet Yechasim of a master and a servant. And avodat Hashem over there is yira'a, okay? And then we said, why is the akara going to be redoomed? Why is she going to have geula? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu loves her the way she is, her ofi, okay? Her personality, and there's no condition. And in the geula of the aniya, okay, of the lady sitting in poverty is from rachamim, ichemla, he feels bad for them, okay? But he has a condition. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, I'm going to come back to you in the condition that you're going to be shomer Torah u'mitzvot, okay? So having said all that, let's go back to Noach now. And I want to remind you that in the tefillot of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, there was a pasuk about Noach. I'm going to read you the pasuk. I forgot to put it on your paper. I'm sorry, but it's going to probably sound familiar to you. Ve'gam et Noach be'ahava zacharta, v'tifkedeu bidvar yeshua v'rachamim, be'aviyacha et mei hamabul, l'shachet kol basar mipnei roa ma'al alehem, al ken zichrono ba lefanecha Adonai Eloheinu, v'leharbot zar'o ke'aforot tevel v'tzeetzaav ke'chol hayam. May Noach, klomar, the whole Mabul of Noach is, first of all, Chazal asks, why is it called May Noach? Noach was a tzaddik. Shouldn't it be called May HaRashaim? Mabul b'tkufat HaRashaim shel Noach? Ma ze May Noach? So Chazal say here something beautiful, exactly what we learned. Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu redeem, ligol et Noach? Lama hu zachar et Noach? Because he loves humanity. He loves the person that he created. HaKadosh Baruch Hu loves us. That's why he created us. He's going to always remember this love that he has for his nivraim, for his, how do you say that, creation. Okay? Ze hasibah shekorim lezeh Mei Noach. Mei Noach, ma ze vezacharta? הקדוש ברוך הוא זוכר שהוא אוהב אותנו, ולכן הקדוש ברוך הוא מבטיח לנו, he promises us that he's never gonna forget the love for humanity, for people, for his creation, ולכן הוא לא יחריב, he's not gonna destruct the world again, because the love that he has for his נבראים, for his creators, creations, okay? זה בדיוק כמו הנחמה של רוני הקרה. זה חזרה ממקום של אהבה. And this is the big, big נחמה that the Navi wants to tell us. Don't worry. Don't worry. הקדוש ברוך הוא is going to always be there to לגאול אותנו. Or because he loves us, just כמו שהוא גאל את נוח. או בגלל שאנחנו יכולים באחריות שלנו, במעשים שלנו, לגאול את עצמנו. אם אנחנו מבטיחים לקיים תורה ומצוות וללכת בדרך הישר, אז הקדוש ברוך הוא יגאל אותנו. מה שנקרא win-win situation. Okay? Either you do your best to get closer to the קדוש ברוך הוא, לקיים תורה ומצוות, ואז יהיה לך גאולה. ואם אתה לא מצליח, if you don't succeed over there, don't worry. הקדוש ברוך הוא loves you. He's going to never forget you. He's going to always come back for you. Just like the husband that left the house in a storm because he was angry at you, but you know that he's going to always come back for you. וזה הנחמה של עם ישראל פה. Because we have three parshiyot that are a bit difficult to start the year off with. Okay? זה הנחמה שהנביא, לכן הנביא מביא גם את רוני הקרה וגם את ענייה סוערה. Okay, he brings these two nevuot to tell us that in any situation אנחנו נגיע לגאולה, יהיה לנו גאולה. Okay? Either בתור מערכת יחסים של איש ואישה אוהבים או במערכת יחסים של אדון ועבד. אז נוח והעולם ניצלים לא בזכות זה שהוא היה צדיק. Okay? את האלוהים מתהלך נוח. Not because of that. אלא בגלל רחמי המקום ואהבתו לאדם. Okay? זה הנחמה שלנו. And maybe I'm going to just say one small thing, one more minute, that there'll never be, again, a חורבן טוטלי, a total destruction of the world, because of the love that הקדוש ברוך הוא has to us. Not because of our מעשים, because of the עצם העובדה that we are his creation. Okay? נכון שאם אנחנו נעשה מעשים טובים זה גם מביא גאולה, אבל ההבטחה העקרונית פה זה האהבה של הקדוש ברוך הוא לעם ישראל, בגלל שאנחנו היצירים שלו, אנחנו כמו האשת נעורים שלו. אוקיי? We can't, הקדוש ברוך הוא לא, או הנביא, לא מבטיח לנו את הגאולה בגלל שנעשה מעשים טובים, because he says you can't rely on people, because sometimes they do right and sometimes they do bad. אז אי אפשר להישען על זה. לכן הנחמה הכי גדולה זה אהבה של הקדוש ברוך הוא לעם ישראל כמו בעל אישה. זה הנחמה הכי גדולה שלנו. And these are the two parts of the נחמה that Yeshayahu brings over here.
כשאנחנו מדברים על חתן וכלה או איש ואישה, זה אחרת מעבד ובורא. זאת אומרת, זה משהו יותר שוויוני. אנחנו משותפים עם הקדוש ברוך הוא. ואנחנו גם, עקרת בית זה העיקר של הבית. It's like the most important part of the house. She's not like a handmaiden. It's not like a marriage where כי הוא לקח אותה. It's עזר כנגדו. She's there to help him, to be a support for him, just like we are. By קיום מצוות, we're also a support for קדוש ברוך הוא.
נכון. אין מלך בלעם. אבל אני רוצה להגיד, לחזק עוד את מה שאת אומרת, בקי. למה חתן וכלה? הרי למה בני זוג אוהבים אחד את השני? למה? למה אנחנו אוהבים? תחשבו על מישהו שאתם אוהבים. חברה, בעל זוג, ילד, מישהו אחר. Why do you like other people? Because of what?
Some of it is just chemistry.
Okay, but not chemistry. It's because of their personality.
Right.
It's because of their midot that they have. That's why you like a person. Okay? And this is the biggest nechama. Hashem says, I know who you are. I love you as you are, even though you did bad things, even though you went off the way. I love you. I love you because who you are. Okay? And that's very different than saying, I will come back to you because I feel bad for you. Or I will come back for you because you're going to do the right actions. זה שונה. אוקיי? ולכן זה בעצם הנחמה הכי גדולה בשבילנו, שהקדוש ברוך הוא יחזור אלינו כי הוא אוהב אותנו, אהבה של איש ואישה. טוב, אז זהו, אז זה בעצם ההפטרה של השבוע. ההפטרה, חז"ל tell us that the minhag is to always have at least 24 פסוקים. And in the first part of רוני הקרה, we don't have 24 פסוקים, we have 9 פסוקים. And that's why the haftara couldn't just end up over there. So what they did is they added more psukim. Sorry, it doesn't have only 10 psukim. It goes on to 15 psukim, I think, right?
I think it's 10.
Yeah, 17 psukim. So זה חלק מהסיבה שחזל אומרים that they brought both of these parts. But I really preferred the pirush that חזל say שהם משלימים אחד את השני. הגאולה הזאת יכולה לבוא ככה או ככה, זה הכל חלק מאיתנו. And let's not forget why are the nevuot written? Why are we reading them? Because it's nitzrach ledorot. It's things that we can see put in our day-to-day life. Okay, if we're sitting in poverty, we can look at the bots, at the dirt, the dirty things that we have in our life, and work very hard and turn them into gems and rhinestones and diamonds and gold and anything that you wish. And on the other hand, you can also, if your galut is not bahuveh aval ba'atid, worrying about the future, so then you can become a dreamer. And the dreams will help us now make our present feel much better. So in any מסלול שתבחרו, יש לנו שם עבודה. אז בעזרת השם שנעשה ונצליח. אז זהו, אז זה לפרשת נוח. You should have a good week. And בעזרת השם בשורות טובות לכל עם ישראל. As usual, it's always nice to see you and learn from you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye-bye. Shavua tov.
Shavua tov.
Shavua tov.